Let's see the next example, example number 29. Here is our input file. To the right of each input string, I have given an arrow symbol and shown what the string should look like after the replacement is done. The input strings are dates. The input date strings follow a format, a three-letter representation of the month, followed by a date number, followed by a suffix like th, nd, st, etc., followed by a four-digit year. If you look at the replacement string, it shows the same date but in a different format. It follows the format date number followed by a hyphen, followed by a three-letter month, followed by a hyphen, followed by a two-digit year. Note that the year is two digits and not four digits in the transformed string. So almost all of the information from the input string needs to get captured and get reused in the transformed string. Let's move to step 2 now. Here, I have tried to represent the input string using regex patterns. Let's start reading from left to right. I have represented the first section using a character class of lowercase and uppercase English letters, followed by the curly bracket repeater with three repetitions. So this will capture the three-letter representation of the month by enclosing it in parentheses. Let's call this capture group /1. Next is the space in the input string. We don't need to capture it, so we will write /s outside of any parentheses and keep moving. Next is the section for the date number. I have used a numeral character class followed by the curly bracket repeater with two repetitions. Let's capture this by enclosing it in parentheses and call this capture group /2. Next, we have the suffix for date like th, nd, st, rd, etc. If you look at the transformed string, we don't use this suffix at all. So we represent it using a character class of lowercase characters followed by the curly bracket repeater with two repetitions. No need to capture it, so we will not enclose it in parentheses. We will move ahead. Next is another space in the input string. We don't need to capture it. Again, we will write /s and keep moving. Next, we have the four-digit year in the input string. We can represent this using a numeral character class with four repetitions. But the problem is that out of these four digits in the input string year, only the last two digits are used in the transformed string. So we will split the representation for this. First, we will write a numeral character class followed by the curly bracket repeater with two repetitions. Then we will repeat by writing another numeral character class followed by the curly bracket repeater with two repetitions. We'll take the last character class alone and capture it by enclosing it in parentheses. This way, we have captured the last two digits of the year alone into capture group /3. Let's now move to the final step. Here we come up with a replacement string. The string should be of the format date number followed by a hyphen followed by a three-letter month followed by a hyphen, followed by a two-digit year. So we write down this phrase. We write backslash 2 in place of date number. We write the hyphen as such. Then we write backslash 1 in place of the three-letter month. We write one more hyphen. And finally, we write backslash 3 in place of the last two digits of the year. So our solution for example number 29 is again a set of two regex patterns. The first pattern is what we came up in step 2. The second pattern is our substitution pattern which we came up with in step 3. Let's try this out now. Let's bring up our Linux terminal. First, let's see our input file. So cat input file name. There you go. Now sed hyphen r and in single quotes s forward slash. We'll type in our search regex pattern for this example. Another forward slash. We'll type in our replacement regex pattern for this example. Another forward slash, g, and then the input file name for this example. There you go. So compare the result here with what you saw in the graphic for this example. Both should match. So that's it for this session. Let's move on to the next one.